I want to speak for a moment about finishing well. You know, Paul says in 2 Timothy 4, verse 7, I have fought the fight, I have completed the course, I've kept the faith. There is an illustration in King David which is very instructive to me. As David reached his last years in life, he was slow to name his son Solomon as king. You know, it may surprise you, you know, as we age, and maybe throughout all of life, we have problems with procrastination. Well, David didn't define Solomon as king. So in the book of 1 Kings, the first chapter, his son Adonijah took advantage of his father's weakness in not finishing well and said, I'm going to be the king. So what happens is fascinating. David knew that Solomon should be king. That's why he was born. That's what God told him early on. So Nathan and Bathsheba get together, and they say to each other, you know, we got to change this. Adonijah has now proclaimed himself as king, and the kingdom will be gone to smatterings unless David steps up and does something. So Bathsheba and the prophet Nathan decide to go in to see David and remind of this. So Bathsheba goes in first and says, David, you need to make a decision here. And Nathan comes in while she's there, and they confirm it. So David realizes what he hasn't done or what he hasn't finished. And he realizes, you know, they're right. I am wrong. I haven't done what I should have done to finish my race well. So he then proclaims Solomon as king, and the kingdom is rectified then because of Solomon being on the throne, because that was God's will. Now my point in all of this, it's very instructive for me. There are things that we need to do to finish life well. And I'm not talking just at the end of life like David was. I don't know how many more years David lived. But there are things in all of our lives at various times that we know we ought to do. So taken from David and finishing well, what are those things in your life and my life that we ought to do well in order to finish well? You know what they are in yours, and I know what they are in mine. So may God help us to take lessons from this story about David and how he didn't finish well and how God used other people to motivate him to finish well. It'd be interesting if you and I would ask other people around us, good friends, what do I need to do to finish well? What do I need to do to finish this season well? What do I need to do to finish my life well? To tell the story of God's faithfulness to me and be faithful to future generations. It really is instructive. I love this passage. May God help us to finish today well, finish this month well, the year we're in well, and yes, to finish our lives well, making the decisions that we need to make. May God speed us to that end.